All right. Giving all praise and glory to the Most High power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. As always, we're going to start out with Colossians 3:17. And whatsoever you do in word or deed, do all. Bahashama Mashiach Yahushai. Give you thanks to the Most High and the Father. Bahashama Mashiach Yahushai. So all that we say and do is going to be in the name of the anointed Savior of Mashiach Yahushai. And we give thanks to the Most High power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Jacob being the forefather of the 12 tribes of Israel for everything. Because he's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. For everything. To the Most High power. So I'm looking at it was brought to my attention concerning anger, you know, being angry. And a lot of attention is drawn to the wicked, the evil of this world. But the Most High told us in 2nd Ezra, the 9th chapter, and 13th verse, it says, and therefore be thou not curious how the unrighteous shall be punished and when, but inquire how the righteous shall be saved, whose the world is, and for whom the world is created. You hear that? So we got to be concerned about more about how we're going to be saved. How our name's going to be written in the book of life. What does it take to be delivered in these trying times that we're in Jacob's trouble? What is it going to take? Is it going to take you doing whatever you think is supposed to be happening as far as banging on Esau? That's what you think this is all about? You'll be redeemed by doing that? I don't think so. See, we got to look at how we're going to be delivered. What it's going to take to change our way of life that we could be the light to everyone, shining bright. And not just to the clique or your clique, which is your church or your congregation. Or your school, and everybody else is in the dark, except for your school, or your church, or the brothers that you congregate with, and sisters that you congregate with. Everybody else in the world is in darkness, gross darkness at that. Look at Ecclesiastes 8:7. It says, rejoice not over thy greatest enemy being dead, but remember that we die all. Hey, remember that we all die, he's saying. So we got to be concerned about how we're going to be saved. Go back to 2 Ezra 9. Because he said he made the whole world for our sake. But the Most High said, verse 7, he said, and every one that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works, by what you do in these mortal bodies, and by faith in your works, is how you follow the Most High's rules and regulations, his guidance that he gave us, being obedient to him. You're going to be able to escape. Why you got to escape? You escaping from something that's coming after you. Escape by your keeping of the Most High's law and your faith in the Most High. Believing in him wholeheartedly. Whereby ye have believed. See? There it is. Your faith is your belief. Believing in the Most High. shall be preserved from the said perils. Perils mean dangers. This is Jacob's trouble. He said it's going to be worse than it ever was in this world. How's it going to be worse than the Most High killing everybody? But Noah, Shem, Ham, and Japheth and their wives, 8 people. But it is. They say drowning is a terrible thing. Drowning is a terrible way to die. But it's going to be worse than that. This is what it says. Shall be preserved from the said dangers, which is perils, and shall see my salvation. Hear that? He said, his salvation in my land, the land of Israel, and within my borders. For I have sanctified, cleaned them up, sanctified them for me from the beginning. He knows who they are. Then shall they be in pitiful case. People going to be in pitiful case. Which now have abused my ways. And that's being disobedient to his rules and regulations, his law, statute, commandments. You understand? They're going to be in pitiful case. And they that have cast them away despitefully, like you're saying, you ain't under the Most High's law. You ain't got to follow him. But you're under mercy and grace. And you're a Gentile. When mercy and grace only came to the Israelites. Because we the only ones that the Most High gave the laws to. Statutes and commandments. And judgments. The covenant to. Abraham, to Isaac, to Jacob, Jacob being the forefather of the 12 tribes of Israel, to the 12 tribes of Israel. Period. Listen. We got to be preserved from the said dangers and shall see my salvation in my land and within my borders. For I have sanctified them for me from the beginning, he said. Then shall they be in pitiful case which now have abused my ways. All you that's sinning, you're going to be in pitiful case. All you sinners, he said, he's going to bring you in pitiful case that have abused his laws. That you say you're not under, or that you believe in, but you don't follow them. You keep sinning. You're lukewarm. Talking to you Israelites too. You ain't trying to be obedient. You ain't trying to be that living sacrifice. You want yours in this world. This is your consolation right here, baby. This is all she wrote for you. If you want it here, in hell, then that's where you're going to be, in hell. Straight up. I can prove it. Don't take much. You're going to say, and they that have cast them away despitefully, some of you doing what you're doing, think the Most High don't see you, shall dwell in torments. Let's see if your anger gets you out of this. Because first and foremost, our people be so angry with our people. You know? They be so angry with our people, their own people. More so than the enemy. Can't get along with the divorce rate. Child abuse. And children abusing their parents. Being disobedient. It's terrible. But he say, shall dwell in torments. For such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me. See? Look, a lot of people, and our people can be drawn to that. They don't know the Most High, but they got money. They got benefits. This their whole consolation. And those that are joined to them going to burn right with them. The riches is this wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. You're going to see this. Or you won't see it. And you continue to do what you do, and then the Most High is going to bring his wrath on you. Especially with us that know, that's taking the time to know him to say, hey, for such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me, and they that have loathed or hated my law, while they had yet liberty, and when as yet place of repentance was opener to them. See, let you know, place of repentance is open to some people, but then the place of repentance is going to be taken away from those that had opportunity to know the Most High in His ways. Do those that know His ways and go deal with those that don't know His ways. You must be examples of what's right, so they could be right and learn righteousness, or you be held accountable. Don't go down right with them. Listen, and they that have loathed or hated my law, while they had yet liberty, and when as yet place of repentance was open unto them, because you hear us saying repent and come back to the laws of the Most High. I'm saying come back to the laws of the Most High, because I know that you that been indoctrinated with religion don't like that word law. Y'all can handle commandments, but law? Oh, no. That's why he have it here. The Most High know. He know what you think. He know how you're going to feel in these last days. He said, they that have loathed, hated my law. Could they get attitude when you say you're under the law? While they had liberty, yet liberty, and when as yet place of repentance was open unto them, understood not, but despised it. See, they despised it. The same must know it after death by what? By pain. You already said torment. Pain and torment. He said, as I quoted initially in the beginning of this lesson, and be therefore thou not curious how the unrighteous shall be punished and when, but inquire how the righteous shall be saved, whose the world is, and for whom the world is created. For us, you know, that's working to be the righteous in the eyes of the Most High. I dare not call myself one of the righteous. And you shouldn't call yourself one of the righteous. That's what Job did. And the Most High sent Satan on him. Somebody else can exalt you, but you don't exalt yourself. And you don't let them exalt you to the point where you get big-headed and think you all that. You ain't nothing. Come forward and show me who you are in the eyes of the Most High. In the Mashiach Yahushua and the angels. If you think you all that. Yasharala, bring it. Better humble yourself. That's what Job did. And the Most High sent Satan on him. He thought he was righteous. That's not marvelous in the eyes of the Most High. That ain't humility before the Most High. You better look at Ezra. He was given 124 books that we don't even have. Well, I say most people don't have. You better look into it. He didn't count himself as one of the righteous. You better look at Daniel. He said, we have sinned. And Daniel and Ezra didn't have to come back to this wicked world. So you're going to rest in their lot till the Mashiach Yahushua come. Told Ezra, you're going to be with my son when the end of days come. Daniel going to be raised up at the end of days. He had to come back to this wicked world. Righteous men, but they said they were wicked. They included themselves with the wicked, the sinners. We have sinned. We all have sinned. That's what's marvelous in the eyes of the Most High. So, yeah. We got to look at this because the Spirit is thinking that you're supposed to be angry. If you're angry, your anger, you can have your classified, Salakia, in the eyes of the Most High as a certain type of person. You got to know when and where to be. Or you can hurt yourself. You can really hurt yourself. Trust me. You need scriptures on that? I can show you. Well, let's go to Ecclesiastes 7 and 9. Ecclesiastes 7 and 9. be not hasty in thy spirit to be angry. You know what I'm saying? Don't be so quick to be angry. For anger rests in the bosom of fools. You hear that? Anger rests in the bosom of fools. What do you think about that? We so quick to get angry, get an attitude. But he said anger rests in the bosom of fools. Call you fools. You got to know how to control your spirit. Be not so quick in thy spirit, in your spirit, to be angry. You see? For anger rests in the bosom of fools. He call you a fool. But then, 1 Corinthians 14 and 40, like I'm saying, everything has to be done this way. 1 Corinthians 14 and 40. Let all things be done decently and in order. So we're going to find out what's decently and in order according to the word of the Most High. And see, some people are not going to be able to deal with this because they feel that them being angry, they have a right to be angry and stay angry and bring forth anger. But you just talking. Like they say, no justice, no peace. Ain't no peace. Ain't you bringing no peace. No justice, no peace. What kind of, how are you taking the peace away from the wicked? Answer that. Marching? Screaming that out? Just running your mouth. And exercising. You watch it. The Most High is going to bring forth the judgment, like we just read, upon the people. We got to be ready and get ourselves ready and be able to please Him. Other than that, that's why He said, look at verse 33. 1 Corinthians 14, 33. For the Most High is not the author of confusion. He ain't the author of confusion. But of peace. How you be angry and get this peace? How everything is done decent in order and you don't have this peace? For the Most High is not the author of confusion. But of peace. As in all churches of the saints. All the churches of the Israelites. He's not the author of confusion. But of peace. So you have to be able to bring our people to this peace that the Most High is saying. And showing them the righteousness of the Most High, which is the keeping of His law, statutes, commandments, and the faith in Him. Believing in Him, as we just read. But those that hated His law, they're gonna dwell in torments and pain. So that's why he came back and said, hey, don't be so concerned about prayer phrases, about how the wicked going to be destroyed and win, but how the righteous going to be saved. He said the righteous scarcely going to be saved. Scarcely. Like, fast as I could, faster than that. He said the righteous scarcely going to be saved. So if the righteous scarcely going to be saved, then how you going to put yourself in with the righteous? But you can't say what number you are at 144,000. You can't say what gate you're going through. You can't say what number you are out of one-third. Humble yourself. For the Most High is not the author of confusion, but of peace. As in all saint churches of the saints. See? Amashah Oshai said the same thing. Go to St. John 14:27. Said peace. It's what you want. Peace. I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world give it. You don't look for the world for this peace that he's talking about here. Give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled. Don't let your mind be troubled. Neither let it be afraid. Then don't be troubled by the oppressor, the wicked, the evil people of this world. Say, don't be afraid. Most I don't give you the spirit of fear, but of power and of a sound mind. And when you understand that power, that spiritual power and a sound mind, to understand how we should operate to please him and not just please ourselves and look for him for whatever it is that he's going to do for us and not what we got to do for him. When he's not the author of confusion, and you walking around with all this confused mind and babal, you that know what I just said, know what I'm saying. Ephesians 4:26 and 27. Ephesians 4:26. He said, be ye angry. See? He said, be ye angry and sin not. You can be angry, but don't break the laws of the Most High. We got to look at what sin is. Sin not. What's sin? All you New Testament buffs that go to church, what's sin? 1 John 3 and 4. And all you that don't want to deal with the law of the Most High. What's sin? 1 John 3 and 4 defines what sin is. Whosoever committeth sin transgresses also the law. The law. It's in the New Testament. Because a lot of times you say the law, Christians and people that have been programmed that we're not under the law, we're under mercy and grace. Just regurgitating what somebody had told them, the tradition of men. I wouldn't even say the precepts of men because they can't prove that from the Bible. We're not under the law of sacrifice. That's it. Now we got to be that ultimate sacrifice. Our bodies have to be a living sacrifice. But that's not to the Gentiles, that's to the Israelites. And you think you're Gentile even though you're Israelites. So you in gross darkness, gross ignorance, not knowing. He said, whosoever committed sin transgresses also the law. You see that? For sin is the transgression of the law. The breaking of the Most High's laws. The breaking of the Most High's rules, regulations, and rules and regulations. Let's go back to Ephesians 4 and 26. He said, be angry, but and sin not. Be angry, but don't break the laws of the Most High, he's saying. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath. He said, don't the sun go down upon your wrath. You see? Don't let the day end and you're angry, and don't let the wisdom that the Most High has given you, because sun represents the wisdom also, depart from you and you bring forth wrath. Listen to what it says next, because you got to understand this, because we're learning righteousness. How do you know righteousness? What's righteous? Let's go to, hold that, Deuteronomy 6:25. Deuteronomy 6 and 25. And it shall be our righteousness. How? And when? If we observe to do all these commandments before the Most High, our power, ours is a personal pronoun showing ownership, possessive, a personal possessive pronoun showing ownership, our power, the Most High, the power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, as he have commanded us. You see? So to be righteous, you got to keep his commandments. So now it's saying, Ephesians 4, 26, be ye angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath. So don't let this law, statutes, commandments of the Most High leave you and you be angry and want to bring forth wrath. Listen to what it says next. Neither give place to the devil. So when you're doing this, you're giving place to the devil. You allowing the devil come into your mind and have you fulfill what it says in Ecclesiastes 3:24. You let the devil come in your mind and fulfill this. Ecclesiastes 3:24. You should know it by heart by now. For many are deceived by their own vain opinion. And in evil suspicion, you allow the devil to get in your mind, hath overthrown their judgment. So the devil gets in people's minds and make them make the wrong judgment call. Because they're rolling with the devil and not the Most High of Mashiach Kelvashah. That's what it said. Neither, what it said in verse 27 of Ephesians 4th chapter, neither give place to the devil. Why do you think it said that? Because you're giving place to the devil by the way you think. Because it starts with a thought. Your thoughts, and then what you say, and then what you do. You understand? So, you allow the devil to come in, and you make the wrong judgment, and now you are held accountable with your actions as you roll with the devil, and it's against the Most High and the Mashiach Yahushua. He said, be angry, but sin not. Don't let the sun go down upon your wrath. I mean, you got to change. You got to, these things, you got to look at and apply this. Surely, we got to bring forth prophecy on the wicked and the righteous. But we got to know how to do it. You got to do everything decently and in order, it says. That's why I look at Ecclesiastes 7 and 7. I know y'all been waiting for this. And this is what brothers use. Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad. Right? So, yeah, we being oppressed, right? But even when you're saying it, you're not oppressed at that moment. Surely oppression make a wise man mad, because you got a roof over your head. Generally, everybody got a roof over their head. You got clothes to put on, garments to put on, food, you know. You got means of transportation to get around, to be able to be wherever you are. When some people don't even have that. But you say, surely oppression make a wise man mad. And you use that to be angry. And it's going to be detrimental to your health if you continue to be just angry. Oh, yeah. Most I got something for all of y'all. And depending on how long you've been in, if your leaders aren't telling you how to come out of that, listen. Let me say something. So being oppressed, feeling oppressed, when you feel that you have, that's like a heaviness in your spirit, hurting you in your spirit. Like, I can think of all the things, I'm getting all kind of information about what's going on. And if I sit here and feel what I know that's happening, I could be very, very, very depressed. It could be very, very, very depressing. Surely oppression make a wise man mad. He said, be angry, but sin not. Right? Don't let the sun go down upon your wrath. So, you are walking around angry all the time behind the oppression that we receiving, that we cause on ourselves, because Most High told us long before this devil, or the people that's coming, that's the devil's on one side and the devil's on another side, the devil's on another side, deceitful and evil people, including our people, that's against us, that you're going to do this to us. And now that we realize we were wrong in departing from the Most High, in learning the way of the heathen, is our fault. You're not going to change? Listen, go to Ecclesiastes, cuss, in the Apocrypha 30:21. It said, give not thy mind to heaviness. We talk about anger. That's heaviness on your mind. It takes a spirit to be angry all the time, to be angry and use the excuse that oppression make of you a wise man mad. Hear what it's saying? Where your peace that Mashiach Oshai say he gonna give you? Where the peace that the Most High say he's not the author of confusion, but a peace? Where your peace you coming from the Most High? You angry. Trust me, I've been there, done that. I know what I'm saying. Because I was there. And had to re-evaluate myself. And doing a self-examination, that's why these scriptures of self-examination start coming out. Somebody told me, why you always angry? I'm like, I ain't angry. Yes, you are. So, whoa, wow. I had to do an assessment of myself. And look at what it says. It said, give not thy mind to heaviness. That's anger. And afflict not thyself in thine own counsel. The way you think. The way I'm thinking. Oh, surely. And you following men. You come in this truth, you start following those your leaders. Following the leader. Now, you tell me out there where a lot of it come from. 2021. And still the same spirit as of old. It's you thinking this is the way it's supposed to be. The spirit ain't never changed. Spirit ain't never stopped. It continued to progressively get stronger and stronger and bringing us to the knowledge, wisdom, understanding of how we should be. Make it mean something different. Or tell me where it began at. Who it began with. At that. Better ask somebody. Listen to what it says, 22. The gladness of the heart, gladness of the mind, is the life of man. Hear that? The gladness of the heart is the life of man. And the joyfulness of a man prolongeth his days. So you cannot be happy and joyful if you walking around angry. You're not joyful. You're not happy. Because you angry. Because you're using an excuse, surely oppression make of a wise man mad. With no understanding. You don't stay there. No, you're not wise. You don't stay there. Listen to what it said. So in other words, you're going to prolong your days walking around angry all the time. I don't think so. You're going to be miserable. And misery loves company. And a lot of cats are miserable. They don't love themselves, so they can't love you. Love thy neighbor as thyself. You start with self, and you love yourself, you got to love someone else. You don't love yourself, you can't love nobody. That's why relationships don't work, because people don't love themselves. You better love someone else. And someone that loves themselves and loving someone else, they can't relate to it because they don't love themselves. How are you going to relate to something that you're not even dealing with yourself? You can't even see it, because it ain't something that's a part of you. But it has to change. It has to change. Listen to what it says. Don't you want your life to be prolonged? Anger going to shorten your days. Listen. Because you read it frontwards and backwards. He's telling you. The gladness of the heart is the life of man. Ecclesiastes 30:22. The gladness of the heart is the life of man. And the joyfulness of a man prolongeth his days. Prolongeth his days. Love thine own soul. And comfort thy heart. Comfort your mind. You can't be comforted being angry all the time. Ain't no comfort in that. Prove it. I'll wait. Prove it. Remove sorrow far from thee. Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad. He said, remove sorrow far from you. If I'm oppressed, I feel oppressed, I'm sorrowful. Ain't no joy in that. Ain't no peace in that. Time and place for everything, brothers. We got to find out what is great for our nation. What works and what don't work. At least that's my analysis of this. If you have something that's better than that, let me know. And I will change myself. Because I only know in part and prophesy, like you know in part and prophesy. In part. None of us got it all. But I know what I believe here in the spirit of the Most High, as it's saying. And I know I had to change. I know I had to change. This helped your health. Help your well-being. Because if you like this, look at what he said. The gladness of the heart is the life of man. And the joyfulness of a man prolongeth his days. So if you angry, you can make your days be short. Because you're going, like, that's why he said, don't bring the devil into your worlds. The Most High said he's going to give you peace. Mashiach said, I'm going to give you peace. When we look at this anger, you give a place to the devil. Where the Most High fit into that? And the Mashiach of Shai fit into that? When you give a place to the devil. If I might ask. With your bad spirit. Say, love thine own soul and comfort thy heart. Comfort your mind. Remove sorrow far from thee. Yeah. We all can look at what's done happened to us and what's happening to us and what's gonna happen to us in prophecy. Some I'll say, because it ain't gonna happen to everyone. And bring sorrow. But you can't stay there. That's the whole key. That's what I say, look, remove sorrow far from thee. For sorrow have killed many. Hear that? Sorrow have killed many. Sorrow have killed many. You giving place to the devil? The Most I say, I'll kill you. I can kill you. Or you want to stay over there with him? And not with me and my son? Okay. Death to you. Sorrow have killed many. Most I said, hey. Mashiach said, hey. This peace I'm going to give you. You ain't sorrow for it. You got peace. Ain't no sorrow in peace. Show me sorrow and peace. Show me sorrow and your love, your joy being fulfilled in the Mashiach Yahushua and the Most High. Show me sorrow in that. For sorrow have killed many, and there is no profit therein. You hear that? Say, envy and wrath shorten the life. What do you say? Be ye angry and sin not. Don't let the sun go down upon thy wrath. So it say, envy and wrath shorten the life. So you envying them? You want to bring wrath upon them? When you going to do it? When you going to do it? You don't know. You have a clue. But you're running your mouth, as I did, and I have done, and might still do, in error. Because I know it part, prophesy in part. I'm not beyond, I'm saying you, but me too, I've been there. So, it ain't. I'm just not talking to you, I'm talking to where I've been, and I could go there. Perfectly. Perfectly. But I know better now. Then I know I'm only going to go so far. I'm not going to hurt myself. Because the scripture telling you, love thine own soul. You see? Love yourself. And comfort thy heart. Comfort your mind. Remove sorrow far from thee. So oppression is sorrow. Make a wise man mad. So you're going to stay angry and mad. Come on. He said, remove sorrow far from thee, for sorrow have killed many. Hear this? You being angry have killed many. Because you can't be happy and be angry. Anger brings sorrow. Your sorrowful feeling. And there is no profit therein. He would say envy and mad wrath shorten the life. Don't let the sun go down upon your wrath. Don't let the sun is the wisdom, first and foremost. Don't allow not having wisdom to shorten your life when you've been given wisdom. The proper application of knowledge, how to apply this knowledge into your life. And you turn from it with your own emotions and your own feelings. That's what it is. You ain't satisfied with yourself, so it's an opportunity for you to bang on whoever. Esau, our people, whoever. Just bang it on them, be angry with them. And stay angry. Envy and wrath shorten the life. And carefulness bringeth age before the time. That's why a lot of you young brothers look older than you are. Because you're so technical. You don't have that peace. You don't have that Most High's love. You don't have that love of the Most High. You say love is the keeping of the commandments. It is. But what do you say over and over again? Love, 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 love your brother. Love your neighbor. Love. Why you got to keep telling us that? Because one way or another, we're going to find some way to hate on ourselves. Like you're going to look at me and find something wrong with me. Because that's her whole gamut is to find something wrong with our people. But what's right? You turn aside to and look for something wrong. When the word of the Most High is wrong, deal with that. I'm nobody. Deal with that. The word of the Most High, make it mean something different. If not, take heed. Going to be weeping and wailing. Look at Ecclesiastes 28:1. Because a lot of times brothers are using the scripture, surely an oppressor make a wise man mad, but his own life is not right once the book is closed. So you take the opportunity to bang on Esau, bang on our people that don't know nothing, as they ought to know, like you know, and I know. And they don't get the opportunity to be able to learn what's right because they already been put down. They're already down when they wake up in the morning. Like I told the brother when he went to Skid Row, man, don't go down there banging on these people. They're already sleeping on the ground. Lift them up. Let them know they're somebody. Learn them what it takes to be able to make it to the kingdom. Like he just said. Don't beat them down more. I already taught them. The curses and all that. You don't got to hear that. You think you showing them something? I've been there over 12 years. Come on. You don't need to hear that no more. We got to learn how we got to be lifted up. They say, exalt others more than thyself. Look on the things of others more than what you have. Lift our people up. We're already down and out. That's why you go to the scripture, surely oppressor make a wise man mad. Because you got issues and you in the truth. You know the truth. The those that don't know, that don't have a way out from what they know and doing and how they living in life. Come on now. You only going to draw a certain people to you. Listen. He that revenges shall find vengeance. This is Ecclesiastes 28:1. He that revenges shall find vengeance from the Most High. You hear that? A lot of y'all want to bring forth revenge. You ain't doing nothing. 30 years, where the revenge come at? Come in at? Running our mouths. Better understand. You hear what he say? He that revenges shall find vengeance from the Most High. And he will surely keep his sins in remembrance. We all the time talking about repent, ask for forgiveness for our sins, and you revision on your brother, revision on whoever. Most of us say, I'm going to remember your sins. We want our sins to be forgot about. But now he say, I'm going to remember your sins. You want revenge against your brother? You ain't loving your brother? So I'm going to remember your sins. You want revenge? See, thinking of something that will hurt your brother and not love your brother and lift him up? So I'm going to remember your sins. And if your sins not forgiven, what you think? Where you think you going? And what you think he going to do to you? Cast your brother to the lake of fire. That's why Master Shai said over and over again, going to be wailing and weeping, wailing and weeping and gnashing of teeth. So you're going to go into hell where the worms never die and the fire's never quenched. People don't believe that because they don't fear the Most High. He said, don't be afraid of the man that can kill the body. After that, he can do nothing. But be afraid of the Most High, who after he have killed, have cast your butt into hell. And we just read about the torment and the pain. Oh, don't get it twisted. You're either going to do right, or that's the judgment, point blank. Listen. He that revenges shall find vengeance from the Most High. Most High said, I'm going to get you. And he will surely keep his sins in remembrance. Ain't no forgiveness of your sins. Forgive thy neighbor the hurt that he have done unto thee. This is our people. This is our people. You got to forgive, yo. The hurt that he have done unto thee. So shall thy sins also be forgiven when thou prayest. You hear that? It says when you pray, he said, forgive your neighbor as an Israelite of the things that they have done against you. And the Most High gonna forgive your sins. Look, go to Matthew 6 and 9 down is the Abba Nawa Palau, the Our Father prayer. So once he gave us how to pray, the Our Father prayer, everybody should know that by heart. He said, in verse 14, Matthew 6:14, for if ye forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. All right? You forgive those that have trespassed against you, the Most High gonna forgive you what you have done. But if ye forgive not men their trespasses, keep in mind what we just read in Ecclesiastes 28th chapter, second verse. Neither will your Father forgive your trespasses, your sins. Trespasses mean sins. Just like we just read. It's all key. Now, look at Mark 11. Like I always say, there is no New Testament. You got to go by what the Old Testament is saying. Mark 11, verse 25. See if it don't coincide with what we just read in Ecclesiastes 28. And when you stand praying, forgive if you have aught against any. You hear that? Forgive. If you have aught, how can you stand praying and you got anger? And you got a problem with this person. You got aught against someone. You gotta be able to let that go. Or you shortening your days. Everybody's days are numbered, but then you shorten your days, he's saying. Well, if you do what's right, then the Most High can allow us to live longer and healthier and without pain and suffering so much. But if you don't, he said, and when you stand praying, forgive. If you have aught, that's a problem, against any, that your Father also, which is in heaven, may forgive you your trespasses, your sins. But if you do not forgive, neither will your Father, which is in heaven, forgive your trespasses. See that? You don't want to forgive, the Most High ain't going to forgive you your sins that you have done. And if you don't allow yourself to have this peace in the love of the Most High. You say, I love Jacob. In the love of the Most High. In the love of we loving our brothers and sisters. Then your sins not going to be forgiven you. If your sins not forgiven you, then what's going to happen? You're going to be part of this. In Mark 4th chapter, Mashiach Shai spoke a parable as he spoke to those that are on the shoreline as he was out in the ship. He spoke to a multitude. He said, some fell by the wayside, some fell among thorns, some fell among stony ground, and some fell among good ground, right? Parable, a riddle. So, in verse 9, Mark 4:9 says, and he said unto them, he that have ears to hear, let him hear. We all got ears to hear. This is what he said. And they had ears to hear. He said, and when he was alone, they that were about him with the 12, so he had some of the multitude, they had enough sense to hook up with the 12 apostles, asked of him the parable, to ask him of the parable, what he spoke of. And he said to them, unto you it is given to know the mystery. That's something that's a secret. The mystery of the kingdom of the Most High. You hear that? It's a mystery. Something that's unknown, a secret. The kingdom of the Most High. Everybody gonna see this. You're gonna see that. He don't want everybody to see this. He said, but unto them that are without, all you that's without, the understanding. I mean, if you want everybody to get this, why he speak his parables? Riddles. So you without, all these things are done in parables. Why? That seeing they may see and not perceive. Like a lot of you read the Bible over and over again. But hang the Bible and say, show me this, show me this, show me that, show me this, a way of life, you can't do it. Because the Most High didn't call you to do that. But yet still, you out there teaching when you need to be taught all over again. The principles of the Most High, the oracles of the Most High. That seeing they may see, this is my Shekel Shai telling you this. That seeing they may see and not perceive. And hearing they may hear and not understand. Lest at any time, just any time in their life, you got to understand this, they should be converted. Any time in their life, they should be converted and their sins should be forgiven them. That's why he just, don't that go along with what he just said? You stand praying, forgive, and you have ought against any, problem against any, that your Father which is in heaven may forgive you your trespasses. But if you don't forgive, then the Most High ain't going to forgive you your trespasses. And he's telling you right here, he don't want everybody to be saved. He don't want everybody to be delivered. Because if your sin's not forgiven you, where do you think you're going?